Hello, happy YouTubers! This is Marceline at CashierGreens.com. Today, we're going to learn how to grow, propagate, and care lipstick plants. Stay tuned! Welcome to my Isinanthus radicans, which is also known for lipstick plant. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to grow, propagate, and care this beautiful hanging plant. Also, I'm going to share with you the tips and tricks how I got this vine rooted like crazy. Let's get started. Are you guys ready? Let's do it. Alright, so let's take few cuttings of our lipstick plant. Now, the requirement of propagation, you need to propagate the plant when it is finished flowering. Like what you see here, it's done flowering. This is the perfect time to propagate. It started flowering in early March and ended in January 1st. It might bloom again in early summer and also in early fall. So it is great to take cuttings of the lipstick plant because once the vine is long, it doesn't age well. It becomes not healthy looking. So if you take the cuttings of the long vine, it increases another new branching. Like what you see here, I cut this one here. Now it has another shoot. There's another shoot again, and also this one. So I would cut at the base right here. So I would probably can take 3 cuttings in one vine. So always apply the principle of sanitation. So what I do here when I propagate plants, especially vines, I have this cotton ball. I spray with alcohol and also spray the cutting. Now once I cut this vine, I'm going to show you it here. So when I cut the vine up to this one here, now it's injured. And once it's injured here, you don't want any fungus attacking to that open wound. So what I mostly do here, after I cut the plant, I rub it with alcohol just to prevent that infection. Now, always carry water with you. So when you take cuttings, you can put right away in the water because you don't want the cuttings to dry out. So by doing this, it keeps the water loss, keep that lock in. So my trick to keep the vine root explode, what I did of my vine, first thing I had to cut this. We'll cut. So I will remove these leaves here. You don't need too many leaves. You just need few. So I will keep 2 leaves here. Now, vine will produce root in the internode. See that? And in the node. So what I did to increase my rooting, so I had to cut in, just injure the stems, just a few slit. So if you put an injury to the stem, it increases callusing, and that is the trick of rooting the stem. So you just injuring it like that, making a cut slit. So what it does, the energy is focusing to building callusing in here. So just be careful when you take a cut here. So this is what I did. Okay, so I make a cut in here, another slit in here, another side. So I'm going to submerge this in water all the way up here, so it will produce roots. To increase my root development and fast rooting, I use Clonix gel. Then I dip my vine. Just coat the whole stem that you want to develop roots. I use 90% of my propagation in the Fagpanic system because this is the only system that will allow me to give me a higher percentage rooting decuttings. The easiest propagation, guys. You don't have to do much and it's very clean. So I'm going to submerge this all the way to the so the mist can mist that whole area. And I will place this back in the system. What is great about using Fagpanic? Because you can root sapwood and also semi-hardwood and hardwood. So there is no limits. And also the insert is designed. Have so many grooves that you can place cuttings. This is also maximizing my growing. So I place that like that. So this is great about the system. And as I mentioned, guys, I would encourage you to get a system. You can build it. I have videos how to build your own Fagpanic. And also you can buy it online. I will link the product below this video. And just like that, that's how easy it is. And then place it back in the system. This is why I always use Fagpanic, guys, because there is no hassle. So after you're done your propagation, always label your cutting, so you know what plant you propagate and also the date, time of propagation, so you can tell when is the time the roots start to develop. Piece of cake, right? You just take cuttings, place in the net cup, put in the system, and voila, you're done. So if you enjoy watching this video, guys, give thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Join our gardening family at cashierqueens.com. Share the video to everyone if you may. So I use 90% of my propagation using the Fagpanic system because it allows me to get a high percentage rate rooting the cuttings. It is easy, fast method of propagation. And also, you can use the system to propagate any kind of plants. You can propagate sapwood cuttings, semi-hardwood cuttings, and also hardwood cuttings. If you are going to propagate sapwood, you can do that in the early spring because plant is active during that month. And if you are going to propagate semi-hardwood cuttings, which normally you are more successful in rooting the cuttings, do it in the early spring and early summer until fall. Then if you are going to propagate the hardwood cuttings, you can still use the system. Do it in the winter. So there's nothing to do in the winter, right? Unless you are going to a vacation. But if you are home, so that is the best time to propagate hardwood cuttings in the winter using the Fagpanic system. Now in the winter time, you need to add another extra help with your system. You need a heater in order for the root to activate. So now let's talk about the care, how to grow and care before I give you the result, because I know you want the result, right? So care of the plant, easy to grow and easy to care. Now, lipstick plant, if you can create like a nature, if you can replicate the nature environment, because it lives in the crevices of the rocks and also in the trees where there is some, you know, crevices in the trees. They're like in the wild. So they like to live in that environment. It doesn't feed the plant, but they draw moisture. So it also helping the other tree when the lipstick plant living on that environment, because it keeps that moisture. So it really needs moisture. If you want to grow the plant, don't allow too dry because it hurts the plant. So you have to make sure that you water them. You can check it with your finger 2 inches down to make sure that it is not it is moist, not dry to the touch. And you can use any type of soil, but I would suggest to use the soil is that it is made for African violet. For those of you who grow African violet, use the type of soil is media, because it has this good quality of keeping the moisture. I use the microgreens, so it is also great in growing the lipstick plant. So are you guys ready for the result? Yes. All right, let's get going. I'm going to close the camera. Camera action. All right, so this is the propagation. Look at this one, guys. Look at that. That is awesome. Now this, depending on the type of plant you propagate, so some plants will root faster, others will take time. So to keep this root like this, now this form, it takes 24 days. So I just keep this one, it's almost like a month now that this root is already established. And how about this one here, this little one here? So how about that? There you go. I split this, guys. I remember when I showed it to you, when I propagated them, I placed in one knit cup. But once it was rooted, I separated them because I don't want to compete the root from each other. Look at that. Look at this. So awesome. How about this one here? Look at... Oh, my. Look at that. Okay, so the next step, we're going to give this plant a good environment, because it is grown in the water, so there is no good nutrients. So we're going to place them in the knit cup and fertilize the plant. All right, guys, I'm happy today because I just had my Mycoplas. Remember, I ran out of Mycoplas and I said I need to get Mycoplas. So this is the product that you are going to apply in your new transplanted plant. What it does, it gives a little bit of nutrients. See that? There's 303. So it is nitrogen, 3%, and also 0 phosphorus, but 3% of phosphate. So it's good for your new cuttings. Now, when you apply the mycorrhizae, guys, is a natural beneficial fungus that is going to protect pathogens that attacking the newly developed root, and also gives nutrients and also preventing transplant shock. Because you grow this one in the water and it is used to that environment, then you transfer into the soil, then there is a change in environment. So I just dip in water so I can stick the mycorrhizae. So just watch me here, guys. Let's just have fun, right? That is what counts in propagation. Just make it fun. If you fail, do it again. So that is how you learn. So I just use this one. See that, guys? Look at how beautiful. So I will place this product, guys, below this video. Check it out. So you just pinch and sprinkle onto root. So it's sticking, right? That is why you had to mess. And now, hold on. Okay, so fill in your cup with soil. I use microgreens, halfway, so don't feel full because it is hard for you to place your cutting. And then you place, you can spread the root, so they can do that. See that? And now you're going to add another extra soil. Soilless. And then you're going to push it down so growing gardening, guys, it takes your mind away, helps relieve stress, right? Okay, so just like that, that's easy. Then after that, we're going to water this. So I will use the same water where I keep for the cutting, just water it. Now plant care, I'm going to give you the plant care. Lipstick plant thrives in bright indirect sun, so I put them in the front of the greenhouse, so it is filtered, the sun is filtered, but it gets a good amount of sunlight, because if you give them proper sunlight, it will increase blooming. Now after you plant this, then you're going to give vitamins. Alright guys, so this is the product that I use here in my gardening. This is awesome. This is 20-20-20, and you can use this in any house plant. You can use, I had this specific for my geranium because I grow a lot of different types of geraniums, so that's why I use this 20-20. It's a good perfect balance of nutrients that is going to help boost my plant. Now when you have to transplant the plant, so a new transplant should not be given a full strength. So this is a full strength, so I will probably just give a little bit and then add extra water. So what I do here, so you can see that it is, I put full spoon. So I just water like that, and then I will supplement with water. And then I will add another water. Now, okay, so indirect sunlight, it needs bright light, but not direct, it is indirect. So fertilizer, you can use 20-20, the one that I used to you, because 20-20 has a balance of nutrients. And also pruning, when you do the pruning, you need to prune the plants when it is leggy. You don't want to have that long vine. You want to increase branching of new shoots, so it increases more flowers, so you take cuttings. So that's what I did here. I kept taking cuttings, and it also keeps the plants looks healthy. Now this is, so far I don't have problem of my lipstick plant. You're okay, right? But mostly bugs, and I don't see any. Maybe if you guys have an experience with your lipstick plants, share that with us, because I don't have problem of my lipstick except this discolor here. Because what happens when it rains, it drips, or when we had that cold temperature, it drips water, and then it creates this acid. They don't like acid. This is a plant is semi-acidic. It prepares semi-acidic soil or alkaline soil, so that's why it burns. Look at that. That's only problem. So if you have problems, guys, show it to us, okay? Because I don't have problem my lipstick here, and it's growing healthy. So probably I would say, or any pests like mites and scales. So again, show that. So that's how I grow my lipstick and how I propagate. And the trick is to cut the vine and also use the clonics that would make your rooting exploded. So this is for today, guys. Thank you for watching. If you have any question, comment below. And also if you experience a problem with your lipstick plant, also write that so that everyone can see it and read your comments. Share to everyone. That's what counts. Thank you again. and see you next time.